Last time on Ashley, the day of the Saturday Night Live performance, my voice was extremely raspy. But little did I know that I was going to completely lose my voice that day. In the middle of rehearsal, my voice, it's like getting raspy and raspy. And I almost wanted to just start bawling. I basically, like, croak. Like, I'm grabbing my throat. It was hurting me so bad, and I couldn't believe that this was happening on Saturday Night Live. Got stains on my t-shirt, and I'm the biggest blur. If you want my autobiography, maybe just ask me.
You don't want to strain it, but just try to do really no speaking.
So we called a doctor onto the set for Saturday Night Live. I was talking to him and he told me that I was going to ruin my vocal cords if I tried to sing on them as swollen as they were. Everybody's conclusion was that I sang to a backing track.
On a Monday.
And the vocal track comes up for Pieces of Me. But we had already played Pieces of Me. I didn't know what to do. Like, inside, I was like, oh my gosh, like, this is live. I was humiliated and so embarrassed, and I couldn't believe that this was actually happening. There was definitely people freaking out, Saturday Night Live people, just, you know, people in the room, just everybody didn't really know what to do, and you know that everybody's freaked out. I woke up the next day not knowing that Saturday Night Live was gonna be as big of a deal as it was. I woke up knowing that it was going to be a big deal, but not that it was going to be on repeat on every news station over and over again. I've worked so hard for what I have, and because of one silly moment, it might be over. And that's scary. So now, I'm going to Las Vegas to do the Radio Music Awards. I'm getting a chance to perform Autobiography. I feel like everybody's staring at me like...
Just be happy and smile.
Smile.
You don't want to look fresh.
People were like, is Ashley's career over? And if my career is over because of this, then that's sad.
A call-in hit on TRL.
Okay.
Here in about 30 minutes, and just telling your story.
Before doing my sound check, I found out that I had a call-in with TRL, and I was talking to my parents about how I was going to handle it.
Okay, do you know what to say for the MTV? Why not? I don't understand why you don't have to say. You say the truth.
I do not say.
I just heard you telling the guy behind you, and you say, I sang through the dress rehearsal. It was perfect. And when it went live, I completely lost my voice.
Say whatever is the most important, you know, at the beginning, because I don't want them to, like, cut you off.
You're like, you know, this just makes me a stronger person. America, another mistake you get to watch by Ashley Simpson.
I don't care what they say about me on the news and all that kind of stuff, but my fans watch TRL.
So here's where we get to clarify some stuff. How many of you guys actually caught SNL this weekend?
There you go.
I'm nervous. How do I sort it out?
They'll ask you, and you just tell them.
Yeah.
Well, like much of America, at least the part that's pop culture obsessed, you guys are probably wondering what went down with Ashley Simpson's performance, why she walked off stage, and whether or not she lip syncs all the time. Joining me right now to explain actually what happened is Ashley herself. Ashley,
hey.
I guess, hey, how is it for you to watch that stuff?
So embarrassing, you know, it sucks because, like, you know, I have severe acid reflux.
And I completely lost my voice at 6 o'clock that night. And my dad was like, I'm sorry, but you have to sing along with the backing track.
So that's the first time that you sang with a guide vocal is what they call it.
Yeah, right?
With a guide vocal. My voice wasn't strong enough. I couldn't even speak.
And it was the first time, and I made a complete fool of myself.
So I
think I just froze, and, you know,
all my fans, like, they know if they've come to my shows, like, I never, you know, sing to a backing track or anything like that. You know, watch the Radio Music Awards tonight.
I think, you know, that's a lot of the questions that, you know, people might have is, why didn't you just start again from the beginning and do the song that you were supposed to do?
I think all of us witnessed State of Shock, and
I was like, oh my God, what did I just do?
I definitely know that the audience here at TRL wishes you the same. You know, get better. See?
It was cool because the fans on the other end were being supportive, and it was really nice to hear that.
Well, get better, and we'll be looking forward to seeing you perform tonight.
Thank you so much.
Baby, just ask me.
The sound check went really good. My voice was back, and it felt good.
We can't touch makeup.
And you're gonna have to.
You're gonna have to touch me up.
So what we're gonna do is the band.
Oh yeah, Pieces of Me
gonna
goes
play
on.
Pieces of Me.
Yeah, and I'm gonna go.
That's the wrong song.
What am I gonna say?
Oh, I thought you said you'd already got it ready.
I talked to my dad about maybe doing something that made light of what happened on SNL on the stage, that I could show everybody that I'm laughing about it now.
I would like to say, well, give him that look like you're really upset, and then go, gotcha, and then hit it. No, I wouldn't even say anything other than that.
Yeah, what if the band screws up the fake screw up, and you end up screwing up because of the screw up?
Oh. Hey, why don't you not put any of those thoughts in her head?
I'm just looking for all the holes.
I just wanted to come over and say hey
Thank
to you.
You so
and
much. It's nice awesome. To meet you. This is Ryan.
Hi. Good.
I had never met Gretchen Wilson before. I love her music. I think she's extremely talented. She came in just to say, screw them all.
I mean, I think some people really are you know, they sit at home and think that everything is live.
I know.
People just
true.
Don't.
Mine definitely is going to be, though. Ashley Simpson, live.
Good luck with everything. I hope all your dreams come true.
I appreciate it. Same here. You're so
nice.
Sweet.
It's nice
Thank
to meet you.
You. Doing the Radio Music Awards is like my opportunity to redeem myself. And this is my chance to prove that I can sing. I was walking to the stage to perform. It was a really cool moment because I had Orion holding my hand. I had my parents with me. I had Stephanie with me. These people all love and support me. I felt like I was at a boxing match. I felt like it was like, all right, here I go. It's my time to come back.
Please give it up for Ashley Simpson.
Woo! The song definitely took on a new meaning at that performance.
I hear you talking.
It felt like I was almost like at the edge of the stage saying, just ask me, or like, you think you know me?
You wanna mess with me? Got stains on my t-shirt, and I'm open. Guess where right now? I'm so over that world of change and eventually.
The perfect song to perform after all of that had happened.
Thank you.
I felt really relieved after it.
It's live.
How did it go tonight?
It went great. It was so nice to get out.
You seem happy again, like you
bounced
back from it.
I totally bounced right back from it. After the show, I had to go do interviews. I held off on the interviews till after I performed, so I didn't hear any negativity.
I had a fine performance tonight. Had a little fun with it, too.
I figured, why not make fun of myself? Surprisingly, the interviews weren't negative.
And, of course, I have to ask you the question. Are your sisters real?
Yes, they're very real. They were actually really nice to me, and I was really happy. I was like, maybe this will all go away now.
Got bruises on my heart and t-shirts on my stains.
Ryan is the most amazing boyfriend. He is my best friend and makes me laugh. he's like the one thing that is like always there for me no matter what.
Me and Ryan are doing a tour where we're surprising high schools and going to perform for them.
Well, change one hand has to go like this. For me, I have to go like this.
You have to do it.
I'm gonna be looking at everyone.
Let's all get in the line.
No, wait, so wait. Shut up. Me and my band have all come together. Everybody knows what they bring to the table, and we all bring something different.
Eye contact, guys. Eye contact.
Hey, what's up? This is Ashley Simpson, and you're listening to 99.3 KISS FM.
So, Ashley, you are in Pennsylvania.
I know.
Harrisburg, Pennsylvania.
Yeah, I know. Isn't that exciting? I was like, where are the restaurants? Where are the restaurants? I was like, oh, there's Arby's. Let's go there.
Yeah, there's really not too much. It's not like a metropolis.
Well, then I saw Olive Garden, so I was like,
Okay, yeah. I was watching on TRL yesterday, and you seem like you have a great like fan base, and it seems like everyone's behind you, so you don't have anything to worry about.
No, my fans have been amazing and like really supportive.
I want to thank you for just doing this interview with us.
Oh,
that's
yeah,
awesome.
Oh my God, of course.
Thank you.
So it came time for all of us to do our snazzy little jazz move on stage. Me and Zach were left alone doing the jazz move. But I was very happy that Zach stuck with me on it. Mom, Jordan called me last night and said they're gonna change my single again from being autobiography. Mama, Eki called me and left me this on my voicemail last night. I'm so over it all. I'm tired. I'm over it. Just ask me.
All right, now lose it.
I'm so pissed.
Yeah.
I'm furious, actually. When I got the call from Jordan saying that he wanted to change the single from autobiography to La La, I was a little bit stressed and upset because I got the phone call in the middle of the night. I'm going through so much right now. Stop changing your mind. At the end of the day, I think Jordan was right because it is a song that I would love to be my single.
Hey, you're just a badass girl.
It's a crazy world.
It's a crazy world. Could you imagine if I had to play at all guys school? It's not fair. See, you can play at all Catholic girls school and be fine. I can't play in all guys school without getting my ass kicked.
I'm gonna leave here like Ryan Cabrera.
We did a show at an all girls Catholic high school. I was watching Ryan from the side of the stage, and they were freaking out for him, and he was totally, you know, flirting back.
Y'all didn't tell me y'all were all such good dancers. I didn't know.
I think something like that is so cool and so cute, and I think every girl should have a crush on him. I'm taking a break from the tour to go home and spend Halloween with my friends.
Guys, what should we be?
Instead of going to one of the cool parties, I just want to stay home and do something low-key. Maybe go trick-or-treating.
We're going to go to Stephanie.
Stephanie, you want to drive my car? Everything's so slutty. What's over here? Maybe I could be this guy. Fat bastard. We'll get some sideburns.
Okay.
And then...
Hi, everybody.
Excuse me.
Oh, sorry.
Excuse me.
Oh, no, that's horrible.
Away from me. No, that's really freaky. Scott, that's one of the best outfits I've ever seen.
Shake your butt. Ooh.
Uh-oh.
Nice.
Guys, play. Play.
Stop.
My back. I got fat bastard.
I got fat bastard.
Oh, my God.
Check out that ass. Give it a slap.
Oh, my God.
I think I broke a butt cheek.
Y'all ready?
Yep.
Let's go.
Come on, everybody.
Oh.
Trick or treat.
Give me something good.
Yay. Thank you. If we all weren't over 20, we wouldn't be so creepy when we walked out of people's houses. Halloween was so much fun. It was just what I needed. Just a nice, relaxing, fun night.
I said, nobody cares about you when you look like this.
I know. I don't think they know who you are.
None at all.
But now I have to go back on the road and finish the high school tour. Shadow went wrong. Ray was handed the wrong guitar, which was out of tune for the song, and it made the song just sound a mess and completely out of tune. It was really hard for everybody in the band to find where they were supposed to be, including me.
It was tuned in tune, but it wasn't in tune to the song. Like, I was playing it because it's in tune, but once the bass and everybody else kicks in, it kicked in a different key.
It's really hard right now when something like that happens, just because all eyes are on me. And the moment that I mess up, or the moment that I have a flaw, everybody's looking and everybody takes notice.
All right, see you later. Bye, guys.
Bye.
See you guys.
Bye.
That's more than 500 people, right?
Yeah. Thinking so.
Doing the in-store was really cool because I didn't know how my fans were going to react. You know, for all I knew, there'd be 28 people there. Cool to be face to face with my fans because they were so supportive and loving, and it was just a really nice, comforting feeling.
Bye, Ashley!
Oh.
Ashley!
It was great to see my fans, but now more than ever, I have to take care of my voice. I have to stay focused.
Bye.
I have to work harder than ever to prove myself. Today is my 20th birthday. My girlfriends are going to take me out for a surprise. My band decided to give me adult gifts.
Man, it's just been fire.
I'm getting my hair cut today.
Wow, you really cut your hair.
Oh my God, Ashley.
Mom doesn't like it.
I was really upset by my mom's reaction. It is a time where I am coming into my own and want to make decisions on my own.
I hope we don't have to go back and reshoot everything.